from the family, from the church here, Bearsden Baptist Church, which has been Jean's spiritual home for the last 6 years. Just welcome to this service to commemorate her life, to give thanks, to reflect on it over the different years that she's been here and before as well. Let's spend a moment in prayer, shall we, just committing the service to the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come into your presence, to just spend time reflecting on Jean's life and faith and her service for you. We just pray for your presence amongst us. Some are grieving the loss, the gap that's been left, but help us to give thanks too for all the good things that have gone on in the past 90 years plus. And there's so much to give thanks for in that. And we commit our time to you here and to the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Amen. Well, if you turn to your order of service, you'll find our first song, and I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing "Morning Has Broken." Appreciate that quite a number of the songs and readings are personal favourites of Jean's, and her niece and nephew, or husband of the niece, are going to come, and Jean particularly liked Anne of Green Gables, and so Diane's going to come and give us an excerpt from that book, and then Simon is going to come and read for us from John 14.
If you are not familiar with the Anne of Green Gables books, they are based on the story of a young orphan girl, redheaded, excuse me for that, with the personality of a redheaded teenager, who was placed with an elderly brother and sister in their farm in Canada. And it's about her exploits with them. The brother and sister were Matthew and Marilla. Totally different personalities. Marilla was very, very organized, very functional. Matthew was the warm, caring, apparently caring brother who Anne loved dearly. And very sadly, towards the end of the first book, Matthew passes away. And I just wanted to share this quote Jean loved these books. She read them many times. And this spoke to me of her as I read it. The news spread quickly through Avonlea, and all day friends and neighbours thronged Green Gables and came and went on errands of kindness for the dead and the living. For the first time, shy, quiet Matthew Cuthbert was a person of central importance. The white majesty of death had fallen on him and set him apart as one crowned.
John chapter 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? And Jesus said to him, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Thank you. Well, who didn't love Jean's kind and gentle spirit and her warm good humor, which was there right to the very end of her life? Her personality developed through a very happy childhood in Battle in East Sussex. Through a very happy childhood, and it's named the town after the Battle of Hastings, which was fought just on the southeast of the village. Many of the generations of the Adams family resided there around Battle for many years, and as well as Joyce, who her sister, who survives her at 98 in Canada, and Colin, her siblings, there were cousins to play with and to explore the neighboring countryside. And Jean came to love the countryside, the flowers, the plants, the trees, as well as the jelly and ice cream at parties. Once she was an adult, Jean worked as a dental assistant in Battle, as a nanny, and had a year in Canada, but unlike Joyce, her sister, she didn't stay. Her best friend Hazel and her husband had started a boarding house for overseas students in Rochester, and they invited her to act as their housekeeper. In her early 40s, Jean might have remained unmarried, but for the intervention of great Aunt Min. And an afternoon tea in 1971, when she was invited along with another acquaintance, Keith Kinshott, Dan's uncle, hoping for romance. Well, romance did blossom, and they were married in 1972, and she moved the 20 miles from Rochester to the Sheerness in the Isle of Sheppey, where Keith worked in the naval dockyard. In Sheerness, Jean became, and she and Keith devoted themselves to caring for elderly relatives and supporting Colin and his children in Battle, who would often come for holidays on the island. She loved reading, Anne of Green Gables being a favorite, music, games, crosswords, but nothing quite beat a scone with jam and cream, which we will, I think, participate in later. And having been brought up in the church in Battle, Jeanne connected with Minster Road Baptist Church, and the prayer meetings and Bible studies became part of her weekly routine there. Keith sadly died in 2003, and she downsized to a new build nearby with a smaller garden, and life continued on as it had done before until 2016, when she felt the need to consider her own care needs. Her niece, Diane, suggested a move to Bear's Den, close to them, and the ideal room at the perfect time came available in Abbeyfield, where she happily spent the last 6 years of her life, just about 400 yards up the road. She attended our own church as much as she could with her health, and it became harder after COVID began. She came to the fortnightly lunch break group, who are going to be serving us teas and coffees later, remembering her in their own way. And her own decreasing mobility ultimately kept her at home more recently. In these last days, the Hettle family have provided a constant presence at her bedside, and she was clear-minded, even as her body weakened, and she kept her great sense of humor. On one occasion, she said, "I'm going on a journey. It's a long journey, but I'm not going anywhere until I finish that clotted cream in the fridge." Well, the clotted cream got finished, and Jeanne went home to be with Jesus almost 2 weeks ago. We're going to sing another song now, which is in your order of service. O Thou Who Camest From Above. So I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing this hymn. Please be seated. I'm just going to reflect fairly briefly on Jeanne's life and her faith And I want to read from Psalm 23, and I'm going to just read a number of verses at a time and then look back on those and what those meant in Jean's life. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. And that was Jean's experience of life. God has always provided and led her to green pastures and quiet waters. From her time as a child in battle, enjoying the countryside around there, the flowers, the trees, and the plants, to Rochester, and then from Sheerness to Bear's Den. At each stage in her life, she was guided along the right path for her. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Now, I'm not sure if Jean experienced many really dark valleys, other than the death of Keith some years ago, but God brought comfort to her when she needed it. And she shared that comfort with others. Many family members who she and Keith looked after from their own home in Sheerness. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Well, Jean didn't actually really have any enemies. Everyone liked Jean. Having a sunny disposition was itself a blessing, and from that overflowed many blessings to herself and to others. And she particularly enjoyed, I'm sure, the meals, the lunches and dinners at Abbeyfield, where they're so wonderfully cared for by the staff there, and enjoy a table with many blessings coming from it, but will be at a bigger and more impressive table today. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Goodness and love are words which came naturally to Jean, for she lived that life here. Those words describe the Lord himself, and where she is now with him is a dwelling which will be constantly and instantly comfortable for her. She said recently, "I always thought I'd be a bit frightened to meet Jesus. But I'm not now." Her heart wasn't troubled any longer. There is room for her in his house. And the words from John 14:6, which Jean trusted in her life, "I am the way and the truth and the life," have proved true for her in her final journey. Shall we pray? Our Father, we thank you so much for Jean and the opportunity to know her. It was a real privilege to come to know this warm, compassionate, kind, and generous person from down in the south of England up here to Scotland. She took that warmth and kindness wherever she went. And we're thankful for that. The family, particularly, give you thanks for her presence in their lives, a beloved aunt. And we just pray for them as they come to terms with losing her. When someone's been around for over 90 years, it just seems like they've always been there, and you expect them always to be there. But the day will come when they go on that final journey, and we're left with a gap. And we pray that you would bring comfort and peace to Diana and the wider family in their mourning today. But comfort them, Lord, with the memories they have of Jeanne, which are all positive, all good. She reflected much of the character of Jesus, even in this life, which few of us can claim to do. And we just commit her to you now and just pray that her life will have impacted and changed ours in some small way for good. And we ask that in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to close our service now with the wonderful hymn, "And Can It Be?" So I'd invite you to stand as we share in this great hymn.
Thank you.
bless you, and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you, Jeanne, and give you peace. Amen. Please be seated. Well, just to say you're very welcome. The family welcome you, lunch break welcome you. The church welcomes you to enjoy some tea, coffee, cream scones, and chat to share your own personal recollections of Jeanne over some refreshments afterwards. And do have a look at the flowers, which were for Jeanne. And they're just lovely colors, the red, green, for this time of year of Christmas. And let's just continue to remember the ways in which Jeanne touched our lives. Thank you.